Everyone, wherever you are viewing us from, this is Benin Empire Advancement League. I want to say you are all welcome to our live broadcast today. Today, before I go into the reason I am appearing live today, I want to first and foremost, extend my warm greetings to all Benin descent worldwide. Whoever or whichever tribe or ethnic group that may have traced and affiliated themselves via historical lineage to the Benin line, I want to say I congratulate every one of you worldwide. My name is, I'm the person of Ewan Joel Iyoa. I'm a proud member of the Benin Empire Advancement League. With due respect, under the direction of the leadership of the Benin Empire Advancement League, I will be presenting to you today a topic identifying one's origin, a step towards positive recognition. Two things prompted this topic and the need for proper explanation to be given, because as we all know, there are a lot of people, even before history was born in Nigeria, a lot of people do not really see the need to read their history. So we are bringing this avenue to enable people have the opportunity to have knowledge of their history. As you may know, without history, one cannot trace its or her existence. History and philosophy is the mother of all subjects that you can take off, because everything in life is historically tied. Therefore, there's nothing that has been done yesterday, things being done today, and things that will be done tomorrow that will not be historic, that has never been historic, and that is not history today. On this ground, I urge everyone to listen, according to Fela Nicola Bakuti, to listen with their open mind. Her organization has been introduced a week ago by our president. Like he said, this organization is a non-governmental organization. And I want to state that we are not a pressure group, so we are not an antagonist as well to any form of pressure group. But at the same time, we want people to understand our vision is to ensure that our people get enlightened in regards to history. Also, we want people to have the knowledge of how they can economically balanced. We have people of divergent areas of school of thought that will be coming live to also educate you, the audience, in various perspectives of life, not just history alone. So our mission is to bring life, to restore sanity and hope to our people. Like I said, the major reason I came out today as introducing my topic, two things prompted that. What are these two things? Firstly, I come to see the inability of so many people not really understanding the nature of history and the basics for which history are made and written in order for it to be transferred to generation to come. Because of the inability of people to read and know about history, sometimes whatever you tell them that are factual, historically, they tend to argue. I came across a comment on Facebook. I wouldn't want to go much into detail. A kind of grandstanding and a skeptical view of the Benin history as it relates to the Ogiso dynasty, which has to do particularly with the issue of Ikaladeran. Somebody commented, and I felt this comment need to be corrected. The comment was that Ogiso dynasty, as claimed by the Benins before the Obaship dynasty never existed, that it was concocted by Oba Eredio in order for the Benins to make the story of a Kaladiran real. I laughed when I saw this comment, and I felt There is need for this to be corrected live. And another reason that also formed this topic has to do with the ideology of people thinking that everyone may be tired according to the language or names they bear. But I am here to prove that the language one speaks or the name one bears may not have to do with its origin. In other words, the name we bear or the language we speak may not denote our origin. Therefore, we have in Nigeria several groups laying claim to several ethnic groups because they are affiliated in terms of languages semblance. Even when the people have come out to say we are not historically related to you, we are historically related to the Benins. Upon migration, it is evident and clear that people migrate far and tend to speak the languages of their close neighbors. And as time goes on, centuries upon centuries, it is possible for there to be a very big transformation of language, which can make a huge difference between the ancestral roots and the offspring on how they speak. But the most important thing of this is the recognition of the fact that we are migrants from a particular area identified without it being imposed on them. On this note, I want to prove that the Ogiso dynasty actually existed and began in the year 40 BC. But before then, it is also of note as factual that even before the 40 BC, when the Ogiso dynasty began, the Benins already have the Odionwaship style of leadership, which lasted for several hundreds and thousands of years. That one may not have been able to measure fully, because we know that before the reign of Ogiso, we had the Edions. So Benin style of leadership has transcended from time to time. The Obaship is not the first dynasty we are having in Benin. And to prove that the language we speak or the names we bear may not denote our origin, as a matter of relationship with neighbors and people, we can acquire some attributes and likeness from them, which enable us to behave like them, sometimes think and act like them. Sometimes we adopt their culture, which sometimes happens. But that doesn't mean we are historically tired. As we know, culture is that which binds people together. And the elements that makes up culture are dancing, singing, attire, and food, and other related stuff. Sometimes these things are adopted due to relationship shared on the basis of friendship, but that doesn't mean we are of the descent of these people. So what I'm trying to point out here is that we have so many languages and so-called dominant language in various ethnic groups that are laying claim to people that have openly come out to say they are Benin. You don't impose on people to tell you that they migrated from you. Rather, you should allow them to say where they come from. That is why the Benin today are so vibrant, to the fact that several groups, several ethnic groups have come out openly to say they are descendants of Benin, and we so much appreciate them, irrespective of the language you speak, the state you live in, the country you live in, as far as you've identified yourself to the Benin origin, you are welcome. I'm going to give you a story. I'm going to give you this story to also prove that sometimes where you are born, the names you bear may not, or the language you speak may not prove or denote that you are from that place. I know of a guy, an American. In fact, he's a missionary in my church. About a month ago, he visited my house. That was his first time of visiting me. His name, an American, his name is Fry, a German name. So when I saw the name on his tag, the tag on his chest, I said, ah, you're from US. He said, yes. He said, but your name is a German name. Is your ancestors, are your ancestors from Germany? He said, no. My ancestors are from Switzerland. I said, oh, the German speaking part of Switzerland. He said, yes. And then I then told him, I said, I know that the Europeans migrated to US so many years ago. He said that is correct. So are you telling me that your grandparents were one of the people from Switzerland, the German speaking part of Switzerland that migrated? He said yes. What has that gone to show? This young man has just proving the point that historically he is not an American, he's from Switzerland, because that is where his parents hail from, his great grandparents hail from. So today he identified the fact that he is an American because even his grandparents were born there, his parents himself, but they still trace their origin to Switzerland. who was with him, I asked him, also an American, I asked him, "And you?" He said, "My ancestors are from Norway." What has that got to show? To prove that the language we speak, and sometimes the name we bear, may not denote the name of the of his companion world speaker. Now, when we talk of migration, people adopting the lifestyle of people, of others around them, it is normal. Today, where the Beninese are happy that a lot of people, notable people, identify themselves with us. That is such a huge super energy to the fact that the history of Benin has never been falsified, but has always been glorified as factual as it has always been. To also prove a point, to the comment I referred to earlier, that the Obiso dynasty never existed, one may know, for those who do not know, they should know, rather, that in the year 1897, Oba Ovonramwen, when the British invaded Benin, exiled him to Calabar. Oba Ovonramwen is the great grandfather of our today present day Oba Ewale Uku Agbolobolo, Ewale the Great. Umokun Obaramwen ever talk me, he said. Oba Ewale is the great grandson of Oba Ovonramwen. If, according to the comment I saw, if it is factual that Obiso dynasty never existed, I am going to prove to you on the interview of Oba Ovonramwen in the year 1914. As at 1914, if by calculation, if Oba Ewale, if Oba Eredeawa, the father of Oba Ewale, was born then, I believe he must have been a young prince. Because the commenter said Oba Eredeawa concocted story of the Caladera, that Obiso dynasty never existed. He said he concocted Obiso dynasty in order to give a Caladera story life. Now here we have the great grandfather of Oba Ewale, Oba Eredeawa. Oba Eredeawa is the great grandson of Oba Ovonramwen. Let's get that right. Therefore, Oba Ewale today is the great great grandson. I don't think Oba Eredeawa was born in 1914. It is not possible that he was born in 1914. It is not possible. To buttress on this, I want people to understand that the story, the history, has always been presented in Benin, mostly in oral form, in tales, and in artifacts. A day before Oba Ovonramwen joined his ancestors in Calabar, an international news called News International 101. At that time, went to interview him. I'm not going to go into details of the interview because that is another day discussion. The last question made reference to this comment. If it is true that Oba Eredewa was the one who cooked up the story of Ogiso dynasty, I want the world to know that even before Oba Eredewa was born, the history were already made. In the last question that was asked by the journalist, the question goes this way, and he said, "Your Majesty, have you any final words?" That was the last question the journalist asked Oba Vorami. And the response Oba Vorami gave to prove, I want to use this response to prove to you that Ogiso dynasty actually existed. Oba Vorami said, "Yes. Tell all the people everywhere in the world that wherever they come across a Benin artwork, they should look deeply at the composition and use the narrative it tells to pass on the history of the great rainforest kingdom that existed on the West Africa coast from 40 BC till the British sack it in 1897. The world should tell our story well." That was the response to the last question that Oba Vorami was asked. Today, what are we singing? The world is singing a new song. What are these new songs? Every day, everywhere, globally, nations around the world, institutions around the world, organizations around the world are coming up to say we want to return the Benin artifacts. That is the new song. I'm also it is very important we understand that Oba Vorami here in his response made mention of 40 BC where the Ogiso dynasty, when the Ogiso dynasty actually began. This alone has come to brush off this barbaric comment. I want to believe that a lot of people need to think twice before they make comments. Otherwise, one will be making a very big mistake. It is not wise that we as a people, as individuals, we say what we don't know or say things based on hatred. It is very important and expedient that we think twice before we speak. Because it is unreasonable, because people like this may think they are reasonable. I want to prove that it is unreasonable for a reasonable man to think that he will never be unreasonable. That is why we make mistakes sometimes. Our mistakes are made under the act of us not being sometimes unreasonable. Therefore, because we are not perfect, we should try as much as we can, especially when it has to do with royals. The Bible said, if any man claim to be religious and bridle not his tongue, that man's religion is vain and foolish. Therefore, to bridle means to control. We should control our tongue, our thinking. Whenever we come across things on social media, it is good for us to filter it. If at all we hate the people, there is need for us to be fair in our opinions, not on the basis of sentiment and hatred. In the 17th century, a book was written by a European concerning the Benin. It described the Benins as a warmly people, friendly people, who accept and entertain foreigners in their land. It described the Benins as peaceful and loving people. And he also described Benin to be a place of less thieves. We are heartwarming, welcoming. Benin is a place of abode for several people. And when we say Benin, we are referring to the Benin Empire. The entire Benin landmarks cut across the map of that contains the Bight of Benin. And across this land, wherever our people are today, irrespective of the dialect we speak, as far as we have all traced our origin to one source, we are all Benins. Now, to prove this point, I want to make a reference to the British, to the era of the Greek rule, the Roman Empire. A lot of people today would say so many prominent people that existed before were Romans. Yes, they were. If not for the fact that the Romans fell in their control of power, they would have still been in charge. So many kingdoms came and fell. That is also what happened to Benin. The most important thing is that we have branches all over the world. The difference between the Benins and the Greek and the Romans is that we have people across the world, across the coast of Africa, that we say we are from Benin. But today, in the Greek and Romans, you can hardly see that, though they controlled so many cities at that time. How many of us would know, and in the Bible, in the Christian Bible, Apostle Paul is referred to as a Roman? Historically, because Tarsus, where he was born and raised, his original home, was part and parcel of the Roman Empire. Today, the present Tarsus is located in Turkey. But historically, it was part of the Roman Empire. The Greek also had their own fair share of world control at the time. The Egyptians did the same. The Benins lost their independence in the year 1897. That is another topic for the day. So many factual evidence are in stock for revelation to be revealed. That I won't go into today. Now, you see, I was talking about Voramy. Ralph Moore, Captain Ralph Moore, who led the British troop with about 1,200 men to burn down Benin City in the year 1897. I tell you, the man died on the 14th. On the 14th of September in the year 1909. He died 5 years before Voramy. How did he die? Because when he was taking Voramy to Calabar on Ezra, Voramy place a curse on him. This man, after his mission in Africa, went back home and became mentally unstable. The gods of the land of Benin wrestled inside of him. Became mentally unstable and he committed suicide by consuming a poison deliberately. That was his reward. He took his own life. It is very paramount that all Benin descendants, wherever we are, we should endeavor to promote our heritage, our culture, for the vast majority of our Benin people, irrespective of the language we speak. When I say Benin, I am not referring to Edo speaking people. We should get that right. When I say Benin, I am not referring to Edo speaking people. In Benin, we have what we call the Edoid. We have 21 languages presently known as Edoid languages, even though we have several descendants that do not speak Edoid language. But the most important thing is that they've recognized the fact that they are Benin descendants, which is against those laying claim to other ethnic groups that have rejected them. I wouldn't want to mention it because we are not here to attack anybody. Like we said, we are not a pressure group, and neither are we against pressure groups. But to set the record straight and right as it is, I feel so much joy when you just like the missionaries, the Christian mission, the religious missionaries, whether you're Christian or Muslim, when they win a soul to their fold, they'll tell you the angels in heaven rejoice because they won a soul. So whenever we identify themselves to be of Benin origin, because Benin historically is so mighty, which comprises of various houses that are now ethnic groups. I'll tell you a story. Between the year 2010-2011, I was privileged to work with an oil exploration company between Edo and Delta State. In Delta State, because at that time, they used to build camp for us. It is only on the occasion when we see that the camp may not be too commodious for us by way of the nature of the forest. Because they used to build camp in forest before you can even access a town. Usually difficult. Most times we stay in the forest inside the camp built with a tent and trampoline and all that. In one of those experiences I had, we were privileged to be in a community in Delta. The reason I'm going to tell you this is to also prove to you that migration from a location by a group of people that are now conglomerated today might not have come as a result of having just one single trip. Migration comes on the basis of intervals in some cases. Some will leave at first, later some other will move and settle near them, move from the same location and settle near them. So also it continues. I never knew, I know our Urobo brothers are of our descent. We are of one blood, one line. I know that. But I never knew that there was the migration process was not moved at once. But it took steps. Several groups migrated. Every group had reasons for migrating at that time. The reason I left might be differ from the reason the other left. That is the case of migration. There is a community along Ugele North local government. That is, the community is along Ugele Port Harcourt Road, for those who know that route, after a community called Irene. In that community, they have a camp by the waterside of that community called Ogunname Camp. That camp is being controlled or governed. It's just a camp, not less than maybe 50 people in there, because there's about just 3, 4, 5 houses there, not more than. But they have a head who controls the camp, who was under the king of Uweru. So the camp, Ogunami camp, is part of Uweru community. But because it is a bit far from the main community, the water side of it was made a camp. And they have a head there who report to the king in Uweru. One day, after returning from the bush as usual, after exploring, I was in the shooting crew. We were the one shooting the dynamite. Without shooting the dynamite, cannot get a sample, a snap, to determine if there is a crude oil or not. That is the final stage of knowing if there is crude oil in that area. Before the shooting crew will come in, a lot of crews must have worked there. We only come, we load the dynamite, we shoot. The platform and the radio house work with us. We radio to shoot like you are shooting a bomb electronically. That's how it is. The sample we have to appear in computer, the control room, they call it platform. Like you're taking a picture, you see the negative, from the negative you watch the original. So it is the sample that determines if there's crude oil. So I was a shooter. I experienced the knock and crown dangers in the forest, both in water, land, swamp. One day, we came back, so we returned. I was washing myself by the riverside and to Gunami camp. I saw this elderly man who was also washing himself. He just returned from the farm. He asked me, "Where are you from?" I said, "I'm from Benin, sir." "Sir, Benin, with all due respect, I respect him so much. He was so generous and fair in his approach." He said, "I'm Benin." He said, "I am a Benin man as well." I said, "Ah, sir, I know you must have been a Benin man because I know that robots are Benin. We are the same. We are not different." He said, "Yes, my own Beninness is as closer as most of the Benin, because you know a place in Benin called Uwelu?" I said, "Yes, Uwelu. That is where the same motor step." I said, "Yes." He said, "This community you see, Uwelu, is another separate Urobo community that migrated separately from that place, Uwelu in Benin. That is why we adopted that name, but corrupted it to Uwelu. Uwelu is being spelled as U-W-E-H-R-O-U. Why Uwelu in Benin is U-W-E-L-U. The only corruption made here is just the arrow and H added with the L from the Benin word removed. Uwelu, Uwelu." I said, "Wow, you mean this Uwelu migrated from Uwelu?" He said, "Yes, we migrated from Uwelu in Benin. The same way our Ishan brothers also have intervals upon migration, so on and so. In most cases, people who migrated from the original home, others, for one reason or the other, also migrated from them to another location. That is how today we also have our people in Ghana, in Togo, Burkina Faso, and so on. Migration has been on the basis of generations upon generations. But the most important thing here is the link, the base of it. What forms the base of this, of the relationship we have? Is our ability to trace and link ourselves to our through our genealogical prospect that has long and well be examined and run it to conclusion that we are descendants of Benin. I want to say, no Benin is greater than the other. We are all the children of the Oba. That is why our royal father has always maintained this stand. Whenever you are good at what you do, the king Oba honors you, irrespective of the language you speak, irrespective of the ethnic group you belong. As far as you are a Benin descendant and you are good at what you do, the king honors you, either with chieftaincy title or fix you up in the palace to also be in charge of or be a custodian of certain affairs as it relates to the kingdom. We have had a lot of people and warriors in the ancient Benin that may not have originally, you know, communicated in this present day Edo language. But with the fact that they were Benins who might have proceeded in communicating in another form, but history ties them to Benin. They were honored. Historically, like the Greek, you have a period where a king becomes an emperor when he controls and rules a certain vast land. Whenever he wants to go to war, there are other kings. They donate army to him because they know they have ancestral roots, a link. They have that which link them up. They know they are brothers. It's like an extended family that donates their own, their household, to participate in a voyage. The mission is to achieve their goal, which the Benin succeeded in achieving. That is why today, I can tell you, the history of Benin is tied, interlinked, has to do with a very vast and elaborate, wider historical track, which often trace and retrace back to the base. The Roman Empire ruled and governed the world. Today, the present Rome is just small city. Rome is a small city today, but they rule the world. That was how the Benin was. Benin ruled Africa. Benin was Nigeria before the name came. I'll give you this evidence. The name Nigeria was actually coined in the year 1914. And it was published in the UK in the year 1914 on the newspaper when Flora Shaw, who later became the wife of Lord Lugard, who had no sire in him. was published in 1914, the name. How many of us truly know that Benin was regarded as the coast of Niger, the Benin Delta, which today is Edo and Delta State, formerly Midwest and Benin. Even though part of it, upon creation of states, were carved out from Midwest, some part carved into Rivers and Bayelsa State of today. So by geographical map, the Benin, the Edo and Delta put together are still be subcharged from the original Midwest map. Let me not go into that. That is another matter for the day. But the bottom line here is to prove the point that the language you speak, the names you bear, may not denote your origin. What denotes your origin is the recognition that you have been able to identify your root. Therefore, no one should lay claim to any ethnic group, not until the ethnic group link their origin to them. We have various numbers of ethnic groups in River State today. The Benin never said to them that they are Benin. They are the ones who came and said, we are Benin. We are of Benin descent. What do? You welcome your home. I was watching YouTube. There's this particular guy I used to follow on YouTube. He's a lover of boxing and one of the promoters of Anthony Joshua. The guy posted a video about 4 days ago. I was watching it. I was amazed. Posted a video where Deontay Wilder himself spoke that he has identified himself to be an Edo man via DNA. Able to get that. And I believe he must have asked questions about the Benins. He said, we are warriors. We wear masks. We fight wars. That is the statement of Deontay Wilder. What do you do? When I am not a follower or a lover of weather, but I must tell you, when I watched this video about 4 days ago, I was pricked in my heart to shift my full support for him. And I bet you, for now henceforth, I am a fan of Deontay Wilder. Personally, I am speaking for myself. I'm not speaking for the group or the Benins. Personally, I have felt that love. And he has promised to come to Benin to learn more about his roots. I'm so much happy for that. Here, I'm saying this to prove that it is not the Benins who went to Deontay Wilder, convincing him to lay claim to Benin. Rather, he made a search for himself and found who he is, where he came from, his roots. That is why when people lay claim to their origin, they not argue are able to prove the point. But when people say they are not of your origin, you cannot impose yourself on them. I am grateful that our brothers and sisters all over the world, who today might not be speaking Mini, the language we speak does not matter. It is not the language that matters. That spirit of love that can never be taken away, according to our brother Majek. That spirit of love that will always be the same should be made to be the same. There is always a unique attribute in all of us that God will prove our oneness, our bloodline relationship as a Benin people all over the world. It is very important we know this. And to also add, a lot of people have an impression when they say the family of Oba Ovorare in Calabar. But I want to say that the Benin descendants in Calabar are not only, rather, let me put it this way, the children or the descendants of Oba Ovorare in Calabar are not the only Benin descendants in Calabar. To put this straight, or to make clarity of this, when Oba Ovorare was deposed to Calabar, there were several chiefs, and some of the palace servants that were taken along with him. They had families there. I can attest to one with proof. Ohen Ogba at that time, for those of us who know Ogba village in Oredu local government, those of us who knows Oko prison, after Oko, the next community you get to there is Ogba, where you have Ogba Zoom. There is a shrine there called Awogba. The priest of that shrine at that time was taken along with Oba Ovorare. His descendants are still the Ohongba today. The Ohongba does not reside in Ogba. The Ohongba reside in Iriri community. And I can tell you, I know what I'm saying. By marriage, I'm an in-law to the Ohongba family because my sister married from that family. In fact, the father of my sister's husband is a direct son from Chief Udin. Chief Udin was the Ohongba priest that was taken along with Oba Ovorare to Calabar. His name was Chief Udin. In the family house of my sister's husband, his own father's house, the front door, if you go there till today, the front door of the house, Chief Udin is great-great-grandfather that was taken along with Oba Ovorare was made into artwork on the door. For those of us who know those days, who our fathers also have a way of using doors, entrance door, to depict history. Shifuddin was has been carved on that door. I asked questions. I was told this is Shifuddin, one of those that was taken along with Obahora. And there is evidence that several of these people that was taken with Obahorame in 1897 later remarried and had children over there. So Obahorame descendants are not the only the Benin descendants in Calabar. I want us to know that there are several many of them that also had descendants that are today Benin descendants. It is paramount that we seek to inquire from our fathers, our household. The Benin historically are known to be storytellers. None of the Benin history is false as far as I'm concerned, because oral traditions, oral form of telling the past has been part of our way of depicting our historical culture. I feel so much joy when I see every day today we have various Benin groups coming out on here promoting the Benin culture. That is what we want. The world, as Oba Ovorami said in the last question that was asking, the response he gave, he said, the world should tell our story well. And the history should be passed out through the kingdom. On this note, I'm going to leave the curtain for today. More days ahead, we have several and more factual evidence to unfold. I want to say thank you to each and every one of you that have participated and viewed this live broadcast. Keep following us. Keep liking us, keep sharing our articles and videos. We promise to always remain on track in giving you as factual as we have it, all that pertains to the Benin history and other areas of life, as far as they are things that will promote our well-being. Let us try and seek to use our mental reasoning positively in ensuring that we don't get deceived by false and unfactual history that is being propagated in social media about the Benin. The Benin is a branch of several ethnic groups with several languages, known as Edward, and so many not Edward connected. But their origin has been identified, connected, accepted, and we always remain as offsprings of the great Benin Empire. On this note, I want to say, not that for me not to take much time, I would have loved to chip in more, want to say personal interest. Therefore, continue to support us, promote us, share our video, like, comment. If you have questions, you can also ask. We will reply you in our page, on our page, in our subsequent time. Thank you very much for listening, for being with us. I want to say, which is very much important, that Obaga Tokbe, Umogwon Barenga Tokbe, Obedo Yaga Tokbe, he said, thank you for being with us. I want to say bye bye for now. Please have a nice day and have a lovely weekend. May God and our ancestors continue to be with you all. He said.